Aloha, I'm Irminne Van Dyken, MD, and welcome back to Out of the Doldrums. Today, we're gonna talk about something that most of us do, but almost no one wants to admit. Scrolling on your phone while sitting on the toilet. And yes, it's linked to hemorrhoids. Now, hemorrhoids are not some alien growth. They're actually normal structures, vascular cushions made of veins, connective tissue, and a little bit of smooth muscle in the anal canal. They help us maintain continence of both gas and stool. They help us form a seal, and they even give us sensory feedback about whether we're about to pass gas or stool. So let's establish this. Everyone has hemorrhoids. It's only when they become swollen or symptomatic that they turn into a problem. So what exactly causes that swelling? Hemorrhoids form when there's prolonged or repeated increases in pressure in these venous cushions. That pressure causes blood to pool, the veins dilate, and eventually the cushion becomes engorged and symptomatic. This is why hemorrhoids are associated with things like pregnancy, heavy lifting, low fiber diets, chronic constipation, and yes, sitting on the toilet for way too long. And here's where smartphones come in. A study just published in PLOS One looked at 125 adults who were undergoing colonoscopy. They asked about smartphone use on the toilet, and then they actually examined whether these people had hemorrhoids or not. About 66% of participants admitted to using their phone while on the toilet. Among those phone users, 37% reported sitting on the toilet longer than 5 minutes per visit. Compare that to only 7% of non-phone users who sat longer than 5 minutes. That's a huge difference in behavior, driven almost entirely by distraction of the phone. Now, here's the kicker. When researchers ran the statistics, smartphone use on the toilet was associated with a 46% increased risk of hemorrhoids. And this was after adjusting for age, sex, BMI, fiber intake, physical activity, and other factors. So the phone habit itself seems to matter. Let's pause and think about why. Sitting on a toilet is not the same as sitting in a chair. When you're in that position, your pelvic floor muscles are not supported. Instead of cradling your rectum, they relax downward, leaving those hemorrhoidal veins hanging, so to speak. Add time, 5, 10, 15, or more minutes of unsupported sitting, and you create venous congestion. Those cushions engorge, and that's when symptoms like bleeding, itching, or pain appear. Now, hemorrhoids can be internal, which usually present with painless rectal bleeding, or external, which can cause itching, irritation, and sometimes clotting that's acutely painful. Both are made worse by chronic venous pressure and prolonged toilet time. So, what can you do about it? Here's my advice, both as a surgeon and as someone who cares deeply about gut health. First, follow the 3-minute rule. If you don't have a bowel movement within 3 minutes of sitting on the toilet, get up, walk around, and wait for the natural urge to return. Don't turn your bathroom into a reading room, and definitely don't turn it into TikTok HQ. Second, prevention starts with the basics, fiber and hydration. Fiber is super important. It keeps stools bulky and soft, making bowel movements easier and faster. Hydration keeps everything moving smoothly through your intestine. Together, they're the most effective ways to reduce hemorrhoid risk. Third, consider your position when you're sitting on the toilet. Using a small footstool to elevate your feet can mimic more of a squat posture, which straightens out the rectoanal angle and allows stool to pass with less straining. It's a simple change that reduces pressure on those veins. And finally, leave your phone outside the bathroom. If you really want to scroll, do it from the couch or somewhere else where your pelvic floor is well supported. So here's the bottom line. Smartphones in the bathroom extend your toilet time. Extended toilet time without pelvic floor support increases venous congestion. Venous congestion, in turn, makes hemorrhoids worse. It's that simple. If you're interested, check out the graphs from the study. I'll put a link in the description below. you're going to see clear differences in toilet time between phone users and non-users. And you'll see the odds ratio, about a 46% increase in risk. This is solid evidence for something many of us have suspected anecdotally for years. So, my call to you, keep toilet time short. Fuel your gut with fiber and hydration, and leave that scrolling for later. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. We love hearing from you, so let us know below what you want me to cover next. Until then, cherish your health and aloha.